Hi guys, today I want to further explore the mysterious underwater UFO phenomenon. UFOs were filmed plunging into the ocean at high speeds with little to no splashing. This is very strange and unconventional. Objects dropped into water make splashes. The greater the speed, the greater the momentum transferred to the water, and as a result, the likely greater degree of splashing. How come there were no observed splashes when UFOs dove into the water at high speeds? Another equally baffling factor is that UFOs were said to maintain their fast speeds while traveling underwater. Water is a much denser material than air, 800 times denser, and accordingly exerts an 800 times greater drag on anything trying to move through it. That's why in the air, we have hypersonic crafts which fly more than 5 times the speed of sound, or over 3,800 miles per hour. In the water, however, our current fastest submarine's top speed is merely 40 miles per hour, which is just 1% of the air speed. We have seen in the movies how water slows down bullets. In real life, water not only slows down a bullet, but also curves and changes the bullet's direction. This is due to frictions, hydrostatic and hydrodynamic drags. Normally, a moving object will slow down and warps its movement when it enters water. Then we must ask, why UFOs can travel at high speeds underwater and make no splashing when entering the water? In my last video, I discussed 4 unique features about UFOs and how they are all tied to one single element, plasma. Plasma can create propulsion in an electro-magneto-hydrodynamic EHD-MHD drive, which is versatile and works in the atmosphere, ocean, and space, just like the bizarre transmedium ability that UFOs appear to possess. Such electromagnetic plasma drives are efficient, quiet, have no moving parts, and use no combustion, all similar to the characteristics of UFOs. On top of that, plasma actuators and a plasma sheath can significantly reduce air drag and shock waves, save fuel, and eliminate sonic boom. A bright luminance in various colors is often seen at UFO night sightings. These glowing lights, the partial or overall plasma sheaths, are not just byproducts of the power radiation, but in my opinion, an intended design. The plasma outlayer would remarkably increase a UFO's flying efficiency and might be part of the reasons behind UFO's otherworldly free-moving and silent maneuvers. What is plasma? In physics, plasma is the fourth and highest energy state of matter, an electrically conducting medium which contains a considerable portion of charged particles, ions, and electrons. Plasma is created when extra energy is added to a fluid, or when the fluid is subjected to a strong electromagnetic field, knocking electrons free from atoms. Plasmas occur naturally, but can also be artificially made. For instance, microwaving a cut grape can make plasma. Plasmas might sound like an exotic matter, but actually, they are the most common ordinary substance, which comprises over 99% of the visible universe. In the night sky, plasma glows in the form of stars, nebulas, and the auroras above the north and south poles on Earth. Because so much of the universe is made up of plasma, its behavior and properties are of intense interest to scientists in multiple disciplines. Plasma sometimes is referred to as ionized gas, which involves complex electricity and magnetism effects with a high unstable energy level, which makes it quite complicated in science. Due to its electrical conductivity, a plasma couples to electric and magnetic fields and is more readily influenced by electromagnetism than by gravity. As a reminder, electricity and magnetism are essentially two aspects of the same thing, electromagnetism. A changing electric field creates a magnetic field, and a changing magnetic field creates an electric field. I've been talking about plasmas in the air. You might wonder, what it has to do with the underwater UFOs? Yes, We want to investigate how the transmitting UFOs can make no splash while plunging into the ocean and continue to travel at high speeds underwater. The thing is, plasma might still be at the center stage with these two intriguing features. Let's now discuss the non-splashing situation. In 2021, a group of Korean and Slovenian physicists published a paper on Nature. The report demonstrated for the first time that a plasma jet has a stabilizing effect on a water's surface. They observed that a plasma jet blowing onto water produces a more stable interaction with the water's surface compared to a neutral gas jet. Gas jets can create dimple-like depressions in liquid surfaces, like when we blow air through a straw directly above a cup of water. As the speed of the gas jet increases, the cavity becomes unstable and starts bubbling and splashing. Well, with the plasma jet blowing weakly ionized plasma to the water, the surface cavity is more stable with less bubbling and splashing. Furthermore, the study showed that a plasma jet consists of pulsed waves of gas ionization propagating along the water's surface, so-called plasma bullets, that exerts more force than a neutral gas jet, making the cavity deeper without becoming destabilized. This paper is a critical step forward in our understanding of plasma-liquid interactions. It's rather interesting to see that plasma has a more stable interaction with liquid surfaces, which results in less splashing than regular gas. Please note that a glowing illumination of UFOs at night is likely due to the plasma sheath. So, when a plasma-covered UFO dives into the ocean, it's reasonable to assume that its plasma outlayer can create a smooth and a non-splashing entry interaction with the water. I'm not surprised that plasma presents this soothing and stabilizing quality with liquids. We have discussed that plasma actuators can greatly improve aircraft's efficiency and streamline airplane movements by reducing or eliminating air drag and shock waves while assisting airflow control. Air is considered a fluid, the gas phase working fluid. The most familiar natural fluid is water. If plasma can reduce turbulence and drag force caused by one type of a neutral fluid, air, then it could well have a matching effect with water and other kinds of neutral fluids. The published paper of Nature proves that indeed, a plasma jet has a more stabilized interaction with water, similar to how plasma actuators can stabilize turbulent airflows. This special feature of plasma might even be of service to the high speeds which UFOs maintained when they traveled underwater. As I mentioned earlier, since water is hundreds of times denser than air, items moving through water encounter a greater deal of drag, therefore submarines travel at a much slower speed. Even with nuclear propulsion, the practical speed limit of submarine is somewhere around 30 to 40 knots. But there is a way around the friction and drag, a technique called supercavitation. The principle behind supercavitation is to enclose a submerged vehicle in a cavitation bubble. With proper design, a cavitation gas bubble is generated at the nose and the drag is dramatically reduced, which enables high speeds. In the 1960s, the Soviets built the world's first supercavitating torpedo, which was capable of unprecedented speeds. Supercavitation capabilities on a submarine have been researched as well. But there are a few major challenges. One obstacle is to create a stable enough bubble boundary layer for submarines to travel through water. Cavitation bubbles are not static and have dynamics of expansion, shrinkage, and collapse. The periodic expansion and contraction of the bubble is known as pulsation and might cause instability. Scientists are trying to understand and tame this continuous cycle of shrinkage and expansion of a gas bubble around an underwater body that occurs during supercavitation. It remains a work in progress. Another downside of supercavitation is maintaining a giant gas bubble is ridiculously noisy. A very loud torpedo or submarine would give away its location immediately and thereby defeats the purpose of stealth. Now, plasma can stabilize air and liquid surfaces, reduce drag, and enhance flow control. Can it be used to help with these two supercavitation obstacles? What if instead of creating a gas bubble to encase the submarine, we utilize an ionized gas or plasma bubble? Can a plasma sheath or bubble enable high-speed traveling underwater in a similar manner as the supercavitation gas bubble? Or maybe plasma can help to maintain the stability and consistency of a gas bubble. This could be a new idea to experiment with, preferably for peaceful purposes. As for the supercavitation noise, currently gas jets are used to generate a gaseous envelope, the bubble for a submarine. And that is where the loud noise mainly comes from. The gas jets impinging on the air-water interface. The turbulence and fluctuations at this interface manifest themselves as a major source of hydrodynamic noise. We already know that plasma has a curious soothing effect on air turbulence. Plus, it can stabilize and smooth water surfaces. In air, plasma actuators can mitigate shock waves and eliminate sonic boom for supersonic crafts. Is it possible that such a device can also come to the aid of the high-speed underwater supercavitation vehicles? So far, scientists don't fully understand the principle of why plasma has special powers to stabilize fluid, reduce friction and drag. It could be related to its conductivity and self-generated electromagnetic fields. Once physicists figure this out, we will get closer to unraveling the mystery of UFOs, since this characteristic of plasma might be the reason why UFOs can travel at amazing speeds both in the atmosphere and under the sea. Here I want to take a minute to answer a question I received from my previous UFO videos. I proposed that UFOs might have used electromagnetic propulsion of a combined EHD-MHD drive with the help of plasmas. Plasma and ion thrusters are not new concepts. They are already operational in space, where there is no air resistance. But they are not used in the Earth's atmosphere because of air friction. Additionally, the current plasma thrusters only make a small amount of thrust. UFOs, however, are well known for their incredible acceleration rates, which means they must have super powerful thrusts in air. If plasma thrusters cannot offer much thrust, then how can the UFOs are using plasma as propulsion? Well, it turns out that there might be better plasma thrusters yet to be invented. In 2020, a Chinese team demonstrated a prototype of a microwave plasma thruster capable of working in an atmosphere and producing thrust with an efficiency that rivals modern jet engines. This new design uses microwaves to ionize pressurized air and turn it into plasma. This novel plasma jet appears to produce an impressive push that may become relevant to electric aircraft applications. By the way, this microwave plasma thruster is just one promising direction to go with future plasma drives. There are probably more potentials and superior ways to create even more powerful plasma engines. And maybe one day, plasma airplanes will be the norm. What I'm saying is this. It's conceivable that certain types of plasma jets can provide great thrust in the air, comparable to a UFO's mighty forces.
Plasma physics is a relatively new field with profound scientific and practical possibilities. There is a lot to learn about this mysterious substance, especially considering how abundant plasma is in the visible universe. Perhaps eons ago, on another planet, a group of scientists and futurists, not unlike our own, wondered about traveling to distant planets, and they made use of the most available matter in the universe, plasma, for their spacecrafts. What do you think? If you like my video, please subscribe to my channel and share with others. You can also support me on Patreon, which is a monthly charge, kind of like you buying me a cup of coffee once a month. I appreciate your support. This is Curious Being. I'm Tina. Thanks for watching and see you next time.